Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to Lightning Gaming. So in today's episode, I've built a horde base just to see how strong spike walls really is. I took one of every kind and I placed a couple of rows with it and we'll send in a day 238 horde and just see how fast they go through the spike walls and if it's really worth having the spike walls for base defense. So first up, I'm just going to place the spike walls. Now first it's the wooden spike walls, the ones that breaks the easiest. Now in the beginning of the game when zombies is chasing you, you can just place one down to block the zombies off. But yeah, it's really really not efficient later on in the game, as we'll see in this video. Next up, the metal one. I'm gonna place that one right over here, just like this. Also a couple of rows. Let me just break that bush real quick. Okay, now these are a little more powerful than the wooden ones, but yeah, I just want to see how it does against the demolishers and stuff like that, and if it's actually worth having in your horde game base on endgame level. Okay, here's the final one, placing them like this as well. Okay, so now they have to go through all of these spikes to get to the ladder, to get to me. I'll be sitting here on top while the horde is going through it. And yeah, we'll just see how much time it takes them to get through this and how fast they progress. Okay, so let's get to the horde and see what happens. Okay, it's finally horde night. I'm just waiting for the horde to arrive. They'll start with the wooden spikes and we'll see if it stops them, if it slows them down, or what the actual use for this is. Because people are using it on the endgame horde bases and I just can't understand why. So I'm just gonna test it out really really simply. We're just gonna let the entire horde run straight over it. Now as you can see guys, that zombies already passed the wooden ones. Almost passed, and yeah, it just doesn't do enough damage. I will see the metal spikes if that helps, but that zombie is just going all the way. Okay, stop now attacking the wooden spike. But here comes the rest of the horde. The spikes are already busy breaking. The cops explode when they hit the spikes. So yeah guys, this is just not really worth it. They're gonna explode your walls if they keep doing that on your horde base. But I still want to see what the demolisher does, if he also explodes when he hits the spikes. This one zombie's almost through our entire trap already. Now it can be helpful if you're sitting with a sniper there in front for the spikes, that slows him down, but yeah, you can just use electric fence for that. Here comes the demolisher. And as you can see guys, he's just eating it up. He's progressing so fast. I don't think he's gonna be able to be stopped by the spikes. But here comes the rest of the horde. He's just killing our spikes. He's gonna make it all the way, I would say. They finally, at least I'm glitched here in the edge frame, so they can't really get to me. That's the closest they can get. But yeah, they already threw our entire trap. The demolishers at least doesn't explode from the spikes. But this just isn't worth it. It's not worth it to use in the endgame base, as you can already see most of the spikes are destroyed. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please remember to subscribe and hit that thumbs up button. Till next time guys, cheers, see ya. By the way, I'm gonna show you how the glitch on this structure works. As you can see, it's a whole hallway and they can't get to me. They just stand there in the beginning, they can't get into this. But yeah, that's a video for another time. Till next time guys, cheers.